Now, design space analysis is in fact the reason to develop a new task model. So, we could consider tasks. So, this means, first of all, I spoke about secondary tasks, and remember that Gen G told me secondary tasks mean a different thing in experiments on usability, right? I'm talking about secondary tasks. We talked about it the first day. Secondary tasks in the terminology of this course mean tasks that are related to using a machine, using a tool, using certain techniques. If we change the machine, if we have a new way of checking for the money to be fake money, just by putting the money in the drawer, if the drawer would shout if it's fake money, then we can do away with the other money, then we have one task no longer there. That's a secondary task. So if we change things, we could change secondary tasks, right? Because the secondary tasks are related to the current technology. If, for instance, if the cash machine would be different and hitting the button of espresso would mean that immediately the espresso machine itself would start making coffee, then the barista is no longer needed. But so I think it will not happen, but the only things we would like to delete is secondary tasks. But we could also create new secondary tasks, like maybe the task of making cookies. If we decide that a good idea to increase the experience is selling cookies, then there could be a new task of baking cookies, right? So secondary tasks could be created or deleted, but don't delete primary tasks. Because if a primary task is to earn money, then you should not take that one out. If the primary task is to advertise today's special, then you should not take it out, right? So only secondary tasks. And the same is, by the way, for this one, the basic task. You remember I spoke about unit tasks and basic tasks. The basic task, for instance, if you work on your computer, is hitting the return key. Now, if hitting the return key is no longer needed, that's fine, right? So basic tasks may go, like secondary tasks. Or you could create new ones if you want. But so this is the possibilities you have regarding tasks. Okay? No primary tasks, no unit tasks. But basic tasks, yes. Agents. If you are redesigning, then you could maybe specify attributes or qualifications. You could specify that the barista needs to be an expert not only on making coffee, but also on making cookies. Now you specify something new about the agent, right? So next time we want a barista who also is an expert in making cookies. Okay, and attributes. Maybe you could decide that for the future, the cashier should be able to speak English to the customers, right? So this is an attribute of an agent that you specify as a redesign. Okay? Another thing is about roles. And you could understand that it's okay to create new roles or okay to delete new roles if it's needed. And if you create or delete the roles, consider whether you mandate or delegate this to agents. So for instance, if you would do away with a certain machine, then you should maybe mandate or delegate the job to another agent, which could be a human agent or could be a new machine, right? So this is the kind of design space. You could change tasks, especially secondary tasks and basic tasks. You could change agents by specifying attributes and qualifications, and you could reconsider roles, okay? And of the same way, you could consider objects. We might have to create new objects, or we could delete objects. Maybe we could delete the objects of the fit card if we would have a machine that would just have a memory about how many times you have been there for coffee. Every time you come there and you order a coffee, the machine could count this for you, and you wouldn't have the need for the object of a fit card, but maybe you like. So, and you could have other rights, so maybe you could allow the customer to stamp its own fit card, or whatever, right? So, and finally, you could reconsider events. So there might be special roles of dispatcher of events. If something happens, then you might identify a special role and connect the role to a certain agent to take care of the event. Right? So we spoke about tasks, agents, roles, objects, events, and for each of these, I try to list here what could change in your redesign. Okay, so your questions should be about these things. Your questions in the QOC, in the design rationale, could be about tasks, especially these ones, could be about agents, especially what qualifications or attributes, could be about roles, how to create roles and to mandate. The questions could be about objects and about events. Okay? And options, well, the options certainly could be about technology. Maybe there is new machines, or we could improve the machine, or we could try to design new hardware. Could be about procedures, like the procedure of handling the VIP card, or the procedure of ordering and by pointing to the menu, or the procedure of the cashier telling the barista what to make, and so on. Could be about the organization, maybe the communication between people, the communication between the staff and the clients, the customers, and about representation, how it would look, the advertisement, the communication, maybe about the dress, like all the people in the shop having a t-shirt that advertises the shop, or about symbols, maybe, well, be careful because the shop has nice symbols, I would say, but there could be ways to use the symbol in a different way. So the options could be about these things, and actually about education or about help or documentation, right? Maybe help for people who don't speak Chinese, or documentation about how to handle the rules. Remember that the shop rules were behind the fridge somewhere, right? So these are the possibilities to do things. Do things by using technology, do things by changing procedures, by changing organization, changing representation, and changing this kind of things. Yeah? So I'm just showing you the kind of things that could help in design. And then criteria. Criteria could be about economic things, so about money. Does it make more money for the shop? Is it worth the expense? Because some decisions would ask for money. Well, would this be worth the result? Acceptability in the context and cultures. So I put culture plural because we already find out there's the culture of the local students who come here every day. But one persona that you didn't mention is the people like me who entered the coffee shop for the first time, being the first coffee shop I ever entered in China, right? So and now I'm already a VIP, so it makes sense to consider different cultures, and it should be acceptable for different cultures or understandable, right? And it should fit the business model. I mean, this coffee shop has a model for selling coffee and people drink it or take it away in a paper cup with a cover. You see, another coffee shop has a different business model where you have tables and chairs and you sit at the table, have a nice glass cup. It's a different business model, right? And it should fit the corporate image. The corporate image, this is not just the picture of 90 degrees, but it's also what was at the outside of the shop, the experience statements in Chinese and English. Well, this is the corporate image, I think. Consider how much time it takes to make the change, if it's just an organizational thing that could be done in a week, or is it building a new machine that takes months or a year? Is it legal? Does it fit the local law and the rules? You cannot just change anything. We could not say the fire extinguisher is not needed. There's never a fire. We take it out. Maybe there's a law that it should be in the shop. I don't know, but I could imagine. And ergonomics, like it should be usable. Yeah? Okay.